All right, guys, today I want to introduce a new workflow for sampling in FL Studio. So I found this shortcut out. If you click the typing keyboard, you could right-click and select your layout for FPC, which means you could use your typing keyboard like an MPC. So we're going to be producing as if we are on the MPC. Firstly, we need a drum break. Okay, let's drag that into Slice X. If you don't see these markers, click the Regions tab, go to Auto Slice, Medium Auto Slicing. So now that we have those, let's open up an FPC, which is like the version of MPC. Go to Presets and Empty. And now again, right click up here, go to C, make sure you're on C, make sure you're in the octave of 4. So right click C and 4, and then go to Layout FPC. So now using my ZXCV and my ASDF and my QWER buttons on the keyboard, and I believe the 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, that's the fourth row, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can now play the 16 pads of the keyboard of the FPC using your keyboard. So let's load up a drum sound per pad. So for the bottom row, we're gonna do drums. Let's just do like simple hi-hat, kick, snare. Now to have both screens open, hit Alt.
Okay.
To have both screens open like this. And then that way you could just drag and drop from Slice X. So let me see where you could see. Okay, I gotta remember my head's in the way. Okay, so with the sample in the bottom left, let's figure out the drums that we want. So firstly, we just want that first kick. Now most people sample all the way up until like the transient. Sometimes you wanna leave room in the beginning of a sound to make it more organic. Okay, so just double click on marker one. We're gonna grab this slice and then drop it on a pad. Okay, so now I'm gonna play Z on my typing keyboard and now it's triggering that kick. So now we need a hi-hat. Now that's like a bouncy snare. So here's kick two. Now, depending on where you like to put your kicks, okay, we'll put them together this time. That one, that kick has a hi-hat on it. So just remember. So you've actually, I'm gonna swap that with a kick that doesn't have a hi-hat. The reason is because I want to make them feel like they're different. So let's grab this, drag it over over the pad. To get rid of a layer, you just click on the layer and then hit delete. Okay, so now we're left with. So again, the reason I have both is because one goes and one goes. So now they can play off each other. Let's find a snare. I believe this is a snare. Okay, and let's drag that one to here. Okay, and the hi-hats are built into the kick. So you really don't need a hi-hat, but let's grab one anyway to separate it. Okay, so now we have the drums. So let's map out the drums real fast. So let's go to the here and let's go 80, turn the metronome on. We're gonna grab pattern one and actually we're gonna go to pattern two. Actually pattern one, whatever. Just hit Control X, get rid of that. We're gonna go to the FPC. At pattern one in. Now, if you're recording by hand, you want to record your drums all the way through for the long part. You don't want to have to keep re-recording your drums because the timing will mess up your groove. So now I'm going to play FPC. That's the rhythm, so let's record that. So I messed up at the end a little bit, but you don't want to stop because this way it loops properly. Now, if you want to add hi-hats, you can go in and add that. So now I'm going to record notes and automation. Now, loop recording is when you have a lot of elements you want to record, like percussion and different things. Let's add the hi-hat. So if you ever miss a hi-hat, you can go back and add it on the second time around. I'm gonna keep that hi-hat really low in volume. I don't want it to be a standout thing. So you can hear all these clicks and pops from the sound because we're taking different chops. So this one, we're gonna create a fade out so that we don't hear that like thing at the end. So grab your envelope and then shape it here. Okay, you pull this in until it gets rid of that click at the end. Okay, there's still like a Okay, so this snare, we're going to tighten it up with an envelope, shorten it out. Now, you don't want to tighten it too much because you can get rid of the majority of the sound. Okay, let's tighten up this hi-hat. See, now the drums feel more clean. Okay, so now we need a sample to go with this. Let's open up a new FPC. Now, when I get to the sample portion, I usually drag the sample into the playlist. I don't like to drag it into any plugins. It's just a lot easier. So I'm going to literally close my eyes, pick a random folder. No specific one. It's called Life is Good. Now, you can find these samples in our Discord. Go to discord.gg/busyworksbeats, and we have a whole section in our Discord with samples you can grab for hip-hop classic albums. That might be a little too big of a sound. Let's see, though. Okay, that's a cool little spot right there. So here's the process. Basically, we're going to take this sample and then time stretch it just this part. So double click. And what you could do before you even do this, go to Options, go to Tools, actually, go to Macros, switch all audio clips to real time stretch. So now everything's time stretched to the grid, but we still have to time stretch it manually. So double click, go to Time, and then lock it in with your time knob. If this stuff is off the grid, like in the beginning, hit Shift Q to lock it to the grid. So now we have all the time markers here. What we need to do is re-render this audio with time markers. So right click, consolidate tracks from track start. And we need to make sure that we save playlist markers onto this actual loop. Now we have all those individual chops, but they're marked in the time marker. Why is this important? Because now when we open up a Slice X, for example, it will have the information in the actual file. Left click and drag it in, and you'll see it has the chop markers in here. Now that we have all the pads, we can play with our typing keyboard. Okay, but the problem is when you play a pad, it overlaps. So you need to go to your envelope in the bottom right and make a sustain envelope like this, and then get rid of the release, turn it on, and then copy the state and click on each pad, click the drop down, go to paste state. Okay, so let's play along with the drums. So let's record this. Let's just tighten up the track a little bit, give it a vibe. So that's the new style of producing in FL Studio using only samplers and loop-based recording. You actually get a pretty unique vibe going. To learn more, go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. Subscribe if you're new piece.